The tutorial system lies at the heart of Oxford's educational experience. Supporting tutorial practices through the use of technology can enable both tutors and students to interact with each other and relevant content before and after their tutorials. Revd Dr James Robson at Wycliffe Hall has used WebLearn, the university's virtual learning environment, for tutoring and supporting his students in their learning and formation.
The Vice-Chancellor of Oxford talked about Oxford's excellence to do with knowledge in three different areas. One was to do with the advancement of knowledge through research. The second thing was the preservation of knowledge through museums and libraries and so on. The third was the dissemination of knowledge through teaching. And Oxford aims to be excellent in each one of those three areas. And it seemed to me that the student experience is not restricted just to the classroom or the tutorial contact, but it's much broader than that. And WebLearn or virtual learning environment can enable that student experience of teaching to be much, much better. Alongside that, I'm also concerned not just for a student to know things, but also their character development and their own formation. And so WebLearn or something like that, a virtual learning environment, enables them that character development too, with a broader contact. Well, first of all, I was a new arrival in Oxford, and so I was keen to develop excellence in teaching, and I came to a WebLearn Fundamentals course and really enjoyed it and saw the real potential for it. And I was quite surprised it was only administrators who were the other student participants, and I thought, there's a real opportunity here. And then I thought, well, what do I do? What kind of tools do I use? And I experimented and thought about what is particularly for the student experience right through from when they receive an assignment right through to getting something back and everything in between. So I used things like announcements to let them know assignments were available. They could submit their assignments online, deal with plagiarism through Turnitin. I'd mark it online. They'd have legible feedback, which would be a great improvement for them. And then have resources that they could work with outside of the class contact or the tutorial contact time. The site, I basically wanted to think from the perspective not of me producing it, but the reader, the user of the site. So I wanted to make sure it focused on the action rather than just general information, cutting out the waffle, making sure nothing was more than three clicks away because people quickly give up, making sure everything was on the page in front of them, you didn't have to scroll down or look somewhere else. And then largely it's about resources, but essentially most of it's about complementing the tutorial or the lecture experience. So it's lots of resources, putting things up in real time depending on what I've done in class or in tutorials with them, putting it up, pooling discussions, that kind of thing. Well, I think in terms of enhancing my own teaching, it's meant that less is more. I'm not so keen to cram everything into a small amount of time, but I can make resources and other things available outside, so I make the most of the learning experience within the class contact or the tutorial contact time. I think from a student learning point of view, for example, they submit their essays in advance, it's gone through Turnitin, I've marked them before the tutorial, so rather than the first 20 minutes of a tutorial being spent in reading it out, I make them summarise it for 5 minutes, and then we bash everything around for the rest of the time and have a... And I think because they know that I'm making an effort with the teaching, they make significant efforts with the learning. They know that it's a serious business and excellence. I work for excellence, therefore they're motivated to deliver excellence. By and large, it's been incredibly positive. So first of all, I've got simple statistics that I've had something like 7,800 separate events that have taken place other than my own, 1,700 visits in what's basically a very small college, and it's only been up a year and a half, so it's had a lot of use, which in a sense shows straight away that it's useful and students appreciating because they wouldn't go otherwise. Then I did a survey to see what do people make of it, and a number of them have been very positive and said, made comments like, encourage other staff to use it, and that sort of thing. I think the first thing I'd say is to focus on the reader or focus on the user, not on yourself. It's quite demoralising to put energy and effort into something and then no one uses it. So getting into their perspective, into their shoes, and what do they want? So cutting out the waffle, making it valuable, the resources, whatever's there is worth them doing, and accessible. so that they can find it easily, because those are the two things that stop students and others making use of things. And then I guess the other thing is it's worth keeping it simple. So don't try and do too much too soon. Just start and start experimenting and ask students for their reflections on what they would like to see. Those are my thoughts. I've listened very much to what the students suggest.